my name is Regan, and this is my friend Jing Jing.
Hi everyone.
We have been working on a 3D printer project for a while, for over a year. And it's based on Scott Russell Kinematics, which we'll be explaining in a bit on the technology behind it. The main purpose of this event is to actually get some nice feedback from you guys on how we can improve the design or you know, other problems that we might face. Actually, for people who are new to the 3D printing industry, I'll just talk a little bit on what's out there in the market. So currently there are four models of 3D printers in the market. The most common ones are the Cartesian and the Delta. The Cartesian is the most stable form of 3D printer. You might have seen a lot of variations in it. The next one comes as a Delta, which came in late 2013, 2012 actually. And then there was another 3D printer company in 2014 called Polar 3D. They have a lot of patents on it, and it's based on polar coordinate system. They have a rotatory planetary gear system. And the last one is Scara, which is still under R&D, and this is the only commercially available product in the market. While actually everyone said that the innovation in the FDM industry is over, we came up with a new model, which is a descendant of the Cartesian system itself. We have identified few limitations from a Cartesian and a Delta printer, and we have actually solved it. And let me talk about the limitations which we feel which can be improved on the traditional systems. So this machine is a descendant of, this is a Cartesian 3D printer, and there are other variations of it. The limitations which we identified is that it has a very small build area, and there are a lot of too many components are involved. So the time taken for building a Cartesian based 3D printer, it's too much compared to the regular Polar or Scara 3D printer. The other important factor is that as the size of the 3D printer increases, the cost drastically increases. So that's mainly because of the components involved in building the 3D printer, especially the outer frame and the hedge belt design of a Cartesian based 3D printer. Then comes the Delta 3D printer. So as you can see, to get the desired build volume, you have to sacrifice on the overall printer height. And if anyone has assembled the Delta 3D printer, you might know that it's very complex to assemble. So considering these two factors, we improved on our design, and I'll let Jingjing do the technology part of it.
A very good evening to everyone. So next I will be talking about the working principles behind our printer. So in order to understand and fully get the full insights of our printer, the first thing we need to know is the Scott Russell. So as illustrated in these figures and this leaf here. So for the Scott Russell of kinematics, it consists of two arms, the short arm and long arm. So for the length of the short arm is actually half of the long arm. So when the point B, one end of the long arm moves towards to the point C, for the other end of the arm, point E, it will move in a straight line motion. And more importantly, the motion of point E is actually perpendicular to point B, to the motion of point B. So in our design, we make use of these features. And for the Scott Russell kinematics, it has been applied in the robotics industry for quite a number of years. So it's a proven technology. Whenever there's a need to change the direction of motion and to make the motion perpendicular, Scott Russell kinematics is always being considered. So following this idea, we came out with our design for our printer. So for this printer, we name it as Kappa. So why do we name it as Kappa? Well, you see from the side, because the power and the long arm and the short arm actually form a letter of K. So K is pronounced as Kappa in Greek. That's why we name it Kappa. Similarly, as the Scott Russell kinematics, we have a long arm and short arms. But what difference is our both ends, it can be moved. So when these two ends move together, it generates a motion of vertical motion. So the nozzle is pointing downwards. And when we fix the bottom end and move the top part, actually the nozzle, you can see it moves inside and outside. So it generates another motion, another direction of motion. Therefore, the third direction of motion comes from the movement of the bat. So the bat itself is movable. So by these three movements, we form a Cartesian coordinate system. That's why we see that kappa is a descendant from Cartesian printer. So and more importantly, in order to make sure that the nozzle is always pointing downwards perpendicular to the printing bed, we use double R in our design. So they form a parallelogram. So whenever, no matter how the arms moves, the nozzle is always pointing downwards. Okay. So this is a working principle behind our printer. Then moving forward, let's talk about some unique features about this printer. So as you all can see, the whole body is made of aluminium extrusion profiles. So it's quite durable and reliable. The tower itself is a unibody, and the cross section is a uniform cross section, so which enables the scalability of our printer. Then all the electronics components is hidden inside the tower. So inside the tower there are three motors, PCB boards, the electricity fans and etc. There are also two homing sensors inside. So for the homing, we use magnetic field sensors. It's a touchless sensor. And some more, the bed itself is removable and adjustable. So it can be easily be attached from the printing, from the printer. And some more, one of our very unique feature is that we offer extra building areas. So on top of this design-built area, actually, if you want, you can print something that is higher than this cube here, due to the nature of the Scott Russell. So with all these features, we do see several advantages as compared to the conventional Cartesian printers and Delta printers. So now I will pass back to Regan to elaborate more on that point.
Thanks, Xingqing. So, yeah. So we are a perfect blend of both the Cartesian and Delta 3D printer. So there are other more advantages which I would like to share here. So the first one is a scalable design. So this is our first prototype and this is the second one, and that is the a test demo piece which we had. So this is of height 150mm, this is of 200mm, and that's of 300mm. So we tried testing out the scalability factor as well in the production, in the prototype cycle itself, and yes, it does work. So this proves that our 3D printer can be scaled at a much cheaper price. And this is the total number of raw materials needed to build two 3D printers, these two together. And this is definitely, it does not include the motors or the bells, but it's definitely half of compared to a Cartesian-based 3D printer. As Xingqing mentioned, the entire printer is made of aluminium and all the motors are housed inside, so it acts as a natural heat sink. So then comes the foldable arm design. So since I work for Pipe3D, I knew this. So shipping is a very hard factor, and manufacturers spend a lot of money for it. So we made our design so that it's easier to ship, and it's completely foldable as well, especially the arms. Then comes in the simplified assembly. Since the number of components are very less, from the point of getting the bomb to assembly is drastically less compared to any Delta 3D printer. And this is a feature which we took from Delta 3D printer. So all the motors are fixed onto the frame itself, so the movable ends are extremely lightweight. And a Delta printer is known for its speed, and we might be able to match the same speed as a Delta 3D printer, or maybe even more. And this is a targeted industry, and we also have a patent on it, and this is where we will be entering the SMEs. So our entire 3D printer can be mounted onto a wall, and the entire bed itself can be folded when the printer is not in use. So this reduces a lot of space, especially for SMEs. And we will be focusing on it after this though. And this is another value-added feature we want to give to our customers. Since our frames are made in 10 meters of length, and we can give them custom defined sizes, just like how you customize an Alienware PC, where you can just choose your height and your width by yourself. How we all started? We started 2 years ago. NUS was kind enough to give us a space to do a car washing robot, and we came up with a design where we could integrate it into a 3D printer because of our experience. And we came up with the first prototype, and then we took our time to do the design and verification with the manufacturer. Then came the first version of the prototype, which we'll be demoing in a while, which doesn't have a custom PCB and stuff. And this is our current version, which is still a prototype. We are still working on it. Then looking at the industry, what we are targeting is 3D printer is a known industry, and we have identified few segments where we'll be targeting. And education is one where we are focusing on integrating the STEAM curriculum into our 3D printer system. Then since scalability is an easier factor, industrial will be the easier bet for us, so where we can enter large scale 3D printing. And the current market is going to be makers and DIYers, and we have identified few features and we are developing it very actively for them. And this is it, so we are still work in progress. Any questions, feedbacks, please approach us. We'll also be sharing a demo of a machine just running, doing a dry print, and you can see it later. Thanks.